So you are just starting your streaming career and you don't know which platform exactly you want to stream on. Maybe you're familiar with Facebook, with YouTube, with Twitch, but you don't know which one is the right one for you yet. Well, the good news here is that you don't have to choose. You can stream on all of them at once and then figure out later which one you prefer. Or another scenario, you've been streaming on a platform for a while now, but you've been wondering if the grass is not greener elsewhere. Well, you can dip your toes in live streaming on other platforms while you stay on your own platform.
Make sure that your contract doesn't go against that.
And today I'm going to teach you exactly how to do it. You'll see how simple it is and how you can set it up in a couple of clicks. So in order to achieve all of that, we're going to be using a service called Restream.io, which this video is actually sponsored by. So let's get into it. So the first step is obviously go to Restream.io and it will bring you to this page where all you have to do is either click get started or log in if you already have an account. So I'm going to log in. And it will bring you to the home. Now in the home, you can pick whatever you want to do and you can see your scheduled events. Yes, you can schedule events with this. Now, if we look to our left, we will see a couple of tabs. Let's click on the little dots here so we can pull them out here. So there's the home, so dashboard pretty much. The events, if you want to create some, you can even click on it. So this is where you would schedule your live events. You have video storage because you're able to record and also upload files. And then you have a tab for your analytics. Now I don't have any streams on this yet, so it won't show anything. Let's go back to home. So in our case, it's going to ask us, what would you like to do? Would you like to stream with Studio? Because they have their own studio, basically a broadcasting software integrated. It will ask us if we want to stream with OBS or a third party software. We are going to be using OBS Studio because I'm assuming that you already have OBS set up. If you don't, there's no worries. You can click top right on your screen right now. And it will bring you to its full tutorial on how to set up OBS for live streaming. As an option, we also have stream a video file, so you can just upload a video file and then live stream it. This is great if you're hosting some sort of like seminar or if you have a presentation, if you're doing like a podcast that is pre-recorded and you would just like to play it live. There's schedule event, we talked about that, and then record only, because yes, you can go ahead and just record straight into Restream. But let's pick stream with OBS. Right? And this is the part where you link your channels. So here you'll see Facebook, Twitch, YouTube, LinkedIn. Those are the basics. This is not all the options that you have. Actually, if you click on add channels, you will see just how many channels you can actually link with Restream directly. Not to count that you have custom RTMP servers, which basically allows you to stream anywhere, really. But for this particular instance, we're gonna pick Twitch. And we're going to connect with Twitch. I'm going to connect to my test account, click login, and then click authorize. And just like that, my Twitch is connected. I can change the title. I can pick the category. Category, let's say just chatting, for example. Boom. And then click save. Okay, so it's going to be giving you tips. You can click got it. And you can see top right here where I have a tab with my chat and destinations. Destinations, we're going to click add channel. And here we can add an additional channel. Let's say YouTube, for example. You click here and then you click connect YouTube. Then you pick your specific channel and click allow. Now, just like Twitch, you can create an event and have the title, description, category, and everything. Click save. And just like that, you're pretty much ready. But let's get into OBS Studio in order to make it communicate with Restream. So here we are in OBS Studio. We have like our starting soon screen. Everything is already set up. My intermission screen is here. My camera doesn't work because I'm currently using it in another software. Let's go to settings real quick. So when we go to settings, you will see a tab called stream, and under service is where you will click and then find restream.io. So I can just put my email and password and log in. Would you like to authorize OBS Studio to use your account? Click allow, and now you're in. Click apply, and you will see a couple of tabs open. You can click okay here. Boom. And those are pretty important tabs because they allow you to modify and keep an eye on the stream while OBS is open. So for example, chat here, very important. Let's drag it to the side, for example. Boom. And we can format it like that. And now we have access to our chat. And the cool thing here, since you can see that both Twitch and YouTube are selected, if anyone types in your chat from whatever platform, they will both appear in this one chat. Unless you go down there to the R, you can click on the little arrow and pick which specific chat you want to see. But Restream is the best because it shows you both at once. Now, I'm not going to be turning those accounts on and off, so I'm going to close this. And stream information is pretty important, so I'm going to keep it to the side. And this is where you can change your title and game right before starting your stream. Click allow. And now, if all of your settings are correct when it comes to the output, your bitrate, your canvas size, the output scale, and all that you need to do from there is click Start Streaming. And then you manage your scene just like you were live streaming normally. You will also have a preview of the stream right here. You can update your titles here. If you want to add an additional channel, you can also do that here. You can have your chat over there. And if you want any additional RTMP pull links, you can create some here. Now, the one thing that's very important, as you can see here, is that your stream will have the Restream branding. If you don't want this, you can upgrade. They have pretty affordable plans. For example, the standard allows you to do so many things on top of getting rid of the watermark. You'll be able to record and store your streams. You'll be able to stream directly to Facebook pages and even groups. And you'll have access to overlays or save your own overlays in the studio. Not even counting the fact that you can stream to more than 30 platforms at once. But I digress. Back to the home, I want to take a sneak peek at the studio just to quickly show you. I will make a specific video on the studio to show you how you straight up do not need OBS Studio and anyone can set up a fully functional live stream. And you can even invite people, have participants, highlight chat messages, and all of that. But that's a story for the next video. So if you have any questions about Restream and all the possibilities, please leave them in the comment section below. I'll do my best to answer them. Make sure you use the link in the description to let them know you came from here, and drop a like and also subscribe so you don't miss when I make the video about the whole studio. Then drop a like and subscribe so you don't miss the next video that I'm gonna make about the studio. I'm really excited about this one. If you like that overlay that I had in OBS Studio, the good news is that it's completely free. It's a full pack that you can get right now over at gumroad.com/getlevel. That way you can have your stream looking all good and ready to stream with Restream. But in the meantime, follow me on social, especially on Twitter. I've been doing a lot of giveaways lately. But yeah, thank you for watching. I will see you guys next time. Go out there, make me proud, get level, out.